We are continuing our shiurim on Matbayah Bracha, the Kavanos of Matbayah Bracha, and we're just going through the first word of the Matbayah, which is Barouch. So we got up to, we're going to do a little bit of revision now in order to just recap what we did last time. So we're up to further on the Kavanah, but we're going to go back to this place. Yechav leham shech shefa mezivuk pinimi. The Chaba the Chagat, the Mar Uben the Al Champi. I don't know if you can see this. No, it's focusing here. Okay, that's a bit better. Okay, so that's what we're doing over here. This Kavanah over here. This line just above the Kavanah. Chaba Lahamshech Shefa Mizivuk Pinim, the Chaba the Chagat. So that is the Shef which came down. Again, remember, we're doing Mochem the Katmas. Mochem the Katmas is also always considered to be Chagat. So that's when Chaba the Chagat, we're bringing down the highest part of the Chagat, which is called the Chaba the Chagat. That's called Zivuk Panimi. That's what's drawn down via the Zivuk Panimi. That's more correct. And we're drawing down from both the right side and left side, Ma'uben, the Al Champim. That was the last thing that we saw beforehand. Now we're going to bring that Zivuk Panimi, which is the Shef, which is called Chaba the Chagat, the Ma'uben, Le'aba Ve'ima Ve'yisosab B'tfuna. So we have the right hand side of the page and the left hand side of the page. This is going to go down to Abba and Yisro Saba, and it's going to go down to Ima and Tfuna. It's represented over here by Havaya and Eke, to show that Havaya is always masculine. The Eke over here is always feminine, so that's going to show you the Kiva. And we spoke about this last time, about the four Mochim de Gadlus, even though we're Mochim de Katnus, we explained Zaremes Ba'alma, that's the Shah Rachamim. And we spoke on the left-hand side, a little bit of problem over here as well, because there's only two Shemas over here, should be four. Like the other side, which is connected chub chub, right? Chokhma bina. That's number one is chokhma. Number two is bina. Number three is chasadim the das and gvur the das. That's the chabad which is coming down. You should have seen that as well on the left hand side. We only have chokhma bina, but we don't have das. We don't have das. Okay? We don't have das. So we said noshim datum kala. That's a sword that's brought down in the Arizal many times. And therefore, because of that, the das is not included in there. And then we said, but that it's also a problem because theoretically, what you should have saw is what we usually see is kasa kasa. Kasa number one is keneged always chokhma. Kasa number two is keneged bina. And this is das already. This kamag, this name over here is kamag. This is already das. We just said nashin datan kala. We're not supposed to be the das. So, it should have been two kasas, not a kasa and a kamag, which represents a bina, or a chokhma, let's say, whichever, and a das. So, what's going on over there? So I saw that,
Kilim.
Right, so there was a chilim between the kilim and the mochim. The kilim and the mochim. The kilim and the mochim. Right. This is brought down in the Shah Rachamim in Chelik Beis Simen Yutes, and also the Pesach Anayim in Daf Gimel Amud Aleph. So they make the Chiliks based on the Shah Kavanos we saw by Abba, Etz Chaim, Shah Abba in Perches Klal Dalit, that he says that he makes a Chilik. When you're talking about Morchim, then you'll find it set up like this, like these four different sets. You'll find Chochma Bina. You'll find kasa, kasa, kama, kana. You'll find that. Here we're not talking about particularly moichim, but we're talking about kelim and levushim. Kelim and levushim, that's what he wants to say. The Rav says, kelim and levushim don't have four, they only have three. So this would be chokhma, this would be bina. In kelim and levushim. And that's what they say, the Pesach Hanayim and the Shah Rachamim.
The problem is that it's easy to say this.
It's easy to say. We can't say it from ourselves. We have to have...
No, but they don't explain what they say. They just keep... They have to finish the puzzles. They finish it the way they can finish it, but...
Again, we have to be careful the lashonis we use. You know, we're talking about Kiddush Elyon, when they say something...
No, I don't mean that.
Often is that, you know, the Megale Tefach and Mechasa Tefachayim. So it looks like they're fudging, looks like, you know, just putting things together. But we invite to ask, we can ask you, but why are we talking about Chal Levushim Kedem here? You know, on the right hand side, we're talking about Moichim, which makes sense. Moichim the Kedem.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
The Remez, this and that. But on the left hand side, it's even more schwer now, because now you're talking about Kedem Levushim. Who's talking about Kedem Levushim? All right. this is how the Mazbi, and they left it open like this. Could be a challenge for our Amunah V'tochen. I don't know why they're not Mazbi Adasov. Why Dafka 2? We don't have all the Hezbeir. Nobody claims to have all the Hezbeir.
The Rashash didn't say this.
The Rashash put down this. He put down Kasa and a Kama.
And they had the question, and because of the question,
we don't change the Kavanah. So,
because of the question, you have to say an answer that you yourself don't understand, because not you.
Again, we're starting on the Gedolim. The Shah Rachamim, Pesach, and I'm
they're giving. It's not our Somer, but we are Somer. I just want to understand what is the mechanism of the answer. Because if they understand what they say, the question would not have started. If they would have known the Musaq of Kelim and Mechim, the Etzem, they would not have asked the question in the Klal. They got the question, and then Al Korach, we have to be Mechadesh, a Chil between Mechim and Kelim.
No, we're not Mechadesh anything. We see in Etz Chaim that there is a Chil.
So what was that the question? You should say, and you should know that he's Kelim.
No, the question, I just told you the question. The question is, what does Kelim and Lushan have to do with this?
Hey, Duke.
That's the question.
No, it's the opposite. You see that those names that won't fit with Das.
No, it's the other way around. It's the other way around. We know in Etz Chaim that these are Kelim and Lushan. But that can't be Pshat here. It has to be Moichim. But it can't be Moichim either, because then it should be Kasa Kasa.
Yeah,
I call it Kelim and Lushan, but because of a Kasha that's Shtap Nishan, we're not going to change the Kavanos.
Yeah, sure not, yeah.
Okay.
But the Ezber is
There's no Ezber, but at least we understand we have a tfisa on the Kavanah.
Yeah.
It's not Stambavir, the Kasakamah, doesn't make sense. You know what I mean? When you say Levush, there's a Mahalach, how that fits in the overall Hamshach of the Moichim, that we don't have the Ezber for.
You said the last time that the third one comes in later or something, right?
Oh, I was going to say the third one comes in later. And that's also going to be a cash of Chalad. What's happening? Why is the third one coming in later? As opposed to should they all came on one go? Okay. So we're going to turn over the page now. When we turn over the page... Let's read the Koteres over here. So just above the Shemus, what does it say? Just above the Shemus, what does it say? It says over here, the Sheva Dema the Zivug de Pinimi, right? The Zivug de Pinimi Anaz, which is the Chabad Chagat, the Achampin, Miponim. Now these three next words are crucial, which was missing last time. We were looking at a text that missed out these very three important words. Mipanim, number one. The Malchias, number. And Chochmos, number three. Now, the Chub de Chub, we understand. That's the Shefa here. That's the Chub and Chug. Right? The Ma'oben, that's right on the left-hand side of that particular... Abba v'Yisosabu, the Ma, because it's all Ma, means it's all right-hand side. The Chab, the Chag, the Arachampi. But what does it mean, the Panim, the Malchias, the Chochma, the Panim, the Malchias, the Chochma. What does that mean exactly? So we showed this chart last time, and this explained everything. Now, let me tell you what this means exactly. So let me give a bit more of a Hezbollah than we had last time. And it sounds like this. So we find in Etz Chaim Shah Yudal Perek Hei Perek Zayin explains to us that we have four different types of Shefa. We have Ab, Zag, Ma, Oben. Now in this Ab, Zag, Ma, Oben we have Eses Sfiras. We have the Kesel of the Ab, Chochmah of the Ab, Bin of the Ab, and so on and so forth. So let's take the Kesa of the Ab.
So there's 10 in all four, or the last one's only got 9?
Why? What do you mean the last one? You mean Ben?
Yeah.
Why should it only have 9?
So it's got 9, because it is Malchus itself.
Malchus also has 10. Everything has 10. Everything is broken to 10. So let's take on that this is Ab. This is a representation of Ab. We could say this by Sag, Ma, or Ben as well. And it's also Mavor that you can say this by Ek as well. You can use this plan to divide all Shefa. So as we're looking at this, this is Ab. Now what sphere of Ab? This is Kesed Ab. All this is one sphere of Kesed. Okay. Now in Keser, it's subdivided again by the Eser Sfiras. So you're gonna have Keser of Ab, Chokhmah of Keser the Ab, Bina of Keser the Ab. You're gonna have the Vak, which is Chesed Gvur Tiferet Netzachot, Hod Yisod of the Keser of the Ab, and also you have the Malchus. So you're gonna have 10 Sfiras over here. But for the purposes of our Kavanas, we only work with the 12 levels. What do I mean by the 12? Yud Dalet Madregas. These are Yud Dalet Madregas. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There's also Mavuah and Shah Rafah, Perikhei. It has to do with Netzus is going. Now, we're not going to go at the length into this chart, but this is what we are dealing with. We deal usually with only the first three of the 10. So it's Keser Chokhmah Bina of the Keser of Ab. And we can do this for every sphere. Now, Keser is always a representation of a Havaya. Every sphere is a representation of Havaya. The Shaila is a Havaya of what? So we're doing it with Ab. So therefore, the Keser is always Pashut. It's always Pashut. So Yud Kei Vav Kei. When you come to Chokhmah is a Miloy of that, of the Ab. So therefore, it's the Havaya, but it's Ab now. It could be Sag, but it could be Ma, it could be Ben, but we're only dealing with Ab. And the Bina is a milu de miloi of the Ab. Again, this chart could have been Sag Ma Uben. We could have changed the computations over here. Mm-hmm. This is the Panim side, and also there's an Achorayim side of the sphere. Okay?
Would that go on forever? Like, Chesed would be the
But we only use in our Kavanas up to 12 levels.
Yeah, I just don't want to know whether, you know.
Okay, our company.
Why? Is it just for convenience? Or why did we change?
These are the Madregas that fell into Bia. I shouldn't have so much.
It shows us
the amount of Netzutzos in every different sphere.
The
Kavanah would be you have to know which Netzutzos fell into Bia, which Netzutzos didn't fall into Bia.
But with the other seven, you need to be having four as well or not?
No.
Because they're ready to be Mesukkan. Or am I confusing it with something, the other thing?
Not really, because we're talking about Keser.
So, okay.
Okay, Akopari. This is only Bikitsu,
right? We're talking about the Shefa here. We're not talking about Tikkunim here. We're talking about this with the Shefa itself.
We're talking about the Shefa.
We're not talking about Rapach. This is the Shefa which is coming down.
Again, what do you mean? What fell into Bia?
Okay, given the Chorayim and
Shefa, right?
Oh yeah.
No,
Shefa didn't fall down.
Rafa didn't fall down.
Yeah, Rafa is Shefa.
Is it?
Rafa Shefa.
Yeah, but the Shefa now is a Baruch. When you bring down, you're not Morit.
Okay, what is Shefa? Shefa is
fuel,
spiritual oil. Stuff.
We call it oil.
Yeah.
Oilers.
Yeah.
Right. So.
But these are all.
Yeah, you want to call it Rafa? Abigazen. You want to call it Sheva? Abigazen.
No,
oil is oil.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to take a little bit of that oil. I'm going to take 288 halakim of that oil. I'm going to take 200 Rafa.
I thought it was different oils from the Tzitzis.
Again, there's only one oil that came off of the nine back. That's it. Zilzin. That's it. So I took 288 chalakim and I put it down to beer, to mechayel the kelim. That's it.
When you say baruch, yeah, you're not moisif a new yerida into beer. The shefa that you bring is not a new kilkul into beer. It's a tikkun. Just before I said baruch,
you're bringing new shefa.
Yeah, new shefa, but not new kilkul. The rapach is a kilkul. You need to be metaken the rapach.
No. Rapach is not a kilkul. Rapach is oil.
Oh yeah, it's the oil which is not in koimoi, and you have to be metaken it.
Rapach is the oil that came up in the Nine Da'ak. It's a chelik. It's 288 chalak.
Did they bury it?
Now.
Yeah, that breaks.
Wait, one second.
Yeah.
Okay. The only thing that broke is the kelim.
The kelim, yeah.
Light cannot break. You can't break light. Oh, okay? Yeah. Okay. But if I leave the kelim in beer by themselves, they're going to dry out and die.
Completely, and they won't be able to fix it at all.
That's right.
Little thing, so the tzor
hakeli, not there's no kikul in the or whatsoever. Yeah, the tzor hakeli, the Eibishter was merachem, and he sent out these shlichim called these 288 nitzutzos in order to mechayev the king. They came out from a big oil.
Yeah, okay.
That's it.
Now, what's the way to be married the kelim back to Atzilus?
You do Torah or mitzvahs.
Oh, so now when you do Baruch, you bring a new shefa.
Which
Kelim give koach to the oil to be married its
Kelim. To be married the Rapach with the Kelim as well.
Correct. And the Shach.
Don't need to be married the Rapach, but the Rapach would be happy to go.
But the Rapach is stuck down there.
Okay, anyway, I think we're really off topic here. All I want to show over here, Aboisa, is the Malchus over here. Because when you look at the individual, this is called the Kesa of Av, this is the Chokhmah. There's two sections, the Teisha Sfiras and there's the Malchus here.
Okay.
That's the division given to us, right? And that Teisha Sfiras are considered to be a representation of the actual letters of the Havaya. And when I say Malchus, you always have to associate to the Gematra, to the Mispah. Okay? Mm-hmm. That's in the Panim side. I could have did that in the Achoraim side as well, but then I would do I would see this type of formation, a Yud, a Yud K, Yud K Vav, Yud K Vav K. That's a different surah, but the same process happens. Teisha Sfiras is the Mispar, Malchus is the Gematria. Okay? Mm-hmm. If I go to Chokhmah, I'm working with the Miloy. But again, which Miloy? It depends. I could be working with the Teisha Sfiras or the Malchus. Okay? The Fizi, we can understand what he's talking about here. What does he say? He says, Shefa dema de zivuk pinima niska de acham miponim. Oh, so we have to look at the ponim category. The malchias. Oh, I have to look at the malchias. Of which malchias? The chochmas. Oh, so here we go. This is what he's talking about. He's talking about the ponim of the ponim of the malchias of the chochmas. That means it's right over here. And this is what is this? Gemata of 72.
So I'm base.
I mean, it's ab.
But we see that in the actual thing.
Because
it's done all four of them.
There's done all. So it's panim. That means he's telling you, look at the panim side. Look at the malchus. Look at the gematria. Meaning, he's telling you that when you look at the shefa, which is coming now, don't look at the actual letters. Work out the gematria. And when you work out the gematria, you see it is the gematria of how much do we say? 232, which is the gematria of Baruch with the four letters. Baruch is 228 for the four letters, 232. So Bekitzur is meramis to you, according to the klolim of the Arizal, that he's telling you, look at the ponim, the malchus, the chokhmah, telling you, work at the gematrias of what you see in front of you. Don't take the letters at face value, but we want to learn out the gematrias.
But they shouldn't be showing us the letters. They should be like having like a bracket showing iron base. That's really what should be showing them. I say is take these letters and then put like this funny bracket, do iron base, or resh lama base, whatever.
Resh lama base.
Or whatever you're going to be.
Right, you want also a marker, a red marker, a blue
no,
marker.
No, but that's ikke kavana.
What?
Ikke chasam in a
sefer. What do you mean
ikke chasam?
It's malchus, no?
No,
but
I see.
Black and white.
I don't see the mispah here at all.
It says malchus, no?
No, but does he show this osius?
Yeah. Chub is ab sag ma oben.
Right.
He's telling you the malchus, take the malchus of it.
But you're not meant to be mechavin this. You're meant to be mechavin the malchus of this.
Meaning the mispah.
It should write the mispah.
What are you talking about? Again, I'm repeating myself like 10 times. Again, when I tell you malchus, what should be the signal in your mind?
The gematria.
Gematria.
Yeah.
That's it.
So where does he bring this?
So you should write the gematria.
What do you mean? Gematria of what?
Of this. Of this.
Again, the way the Rashash
is
written like this. He writes a title, okay? And then he shows you what he's talking about. Okay? So the title is telling you the Malchus of the Chochmah of Chub de Chub, and he's showing you a picture of it.
Right. So maybe Mechavah the Malchus of this.
That's right. Mechavah the Malchus of the
Chochmah. So the Rashash actually wrote this.
Yes, the Rashash actually wrote this.
All these shamers.
That's right.
Hey, but not this. Oh, but not this.
He wrote everything.
This as well?
Yes. Yes. Yeah. That's the Rashash.
It's not just someone interpreting the Rashash.
No. This is the Rashash. He writes you an explanation. You have to then shows this. You a picture, and it's
right. So you can't just pick up this is a Rashash and just read through it. Oh, I'm having this. You actually have to read this very carefully and know what you're doing.
You have to know it's time. You have to know what you're doing. You have to know what you're doing. Yes.
So what you could do is you could write down the gematrias as on the actual siddur itself, just to remind you. Oh, here's the gematria. If you want to daven a bit quicker, then
you can do whatever you want, as long as you don't publish it.
No, why not? You need to publish it.
Oh, because you're not going to change your Rashash.
That's right. So there's a tshuva in. We'll speak about chaperim with the siddur. A lot of people are very upset with people.
What's the ayin? So how it comes as ayin base? If you say it's a chochma, you say it's ayin base. It's a mystical iron base, and you say no, it's not iron base, it's the whole shame.
That's the other question I had.
The Malch is the Chochmah. The Chochmah.
Can you be sure the first line
Ab,
understand?
This is Abzai. This is all of them. Ab. Right.
The Malch is the Chochmah.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Okay.
No.
That's right. This chart. Yeah. Look. That's right.
70. This 72.
That means
72,
if
72.
I were to show you four of these charts.
Well, 72,
this is the ab chart.
No. 72, 72.
Then you have also a sag chart.
Of chum chum.
It looks exactly the same. And I show ma chart.
Well, chum
as I'm changing
this is
the chokhmah ab, that would be this. So when I'm talking about the sag chart, you would see a sag over here, and then when I say everything would be changed according to the chuppah, right?
Really, Mr. Finatubo, kavanat harashash ikacha. This is not the malchus, the chokhmah, or these four lines.
This is just the chokhmah. This is the chokhmah chart, basically. And you have a bina one, you have a chasad and das chart, and you have a gvur das chart.
I just told you that. You have four of these charts.
Yeah, I'm just repeating yourself to make sure.
Right, you have four of these charts. This is the ab chart, but you find the same thing in the sag chart, except you have sag here also.
Yeah, but you get.
And then you have ma, and then you have ben, four of them. That's what he's telling you over here.
So this
now
is
the shah has a
kasher. All that is in the kasher
of ab. Ben, he's calling it chub and chug.
That's right. Chub and chug. Now,
and this is all in the kasher of ab.
Now you have to understand there's a rule in the Rashash called Ab as a Kitzer. There's a lot of caches on the Rashash. Why this, why that, why didn't he tell us more information? But they always answer the same that Ab as a Kitzer. And a Hanami, you're right, Maskavim. So you're right, the Rashash should have said they should add more, should have said this and that. Right, like you say right now, why didn't you write the Ab, why didn't you write down this and that? It's not. It's chosser, right? We see oisis here. He should write the gematria of each line, right?
He wrote it
already in the introduction. I was a kid, so he just writes down quickly and he moves on.
Right.
He's supposed to know.
Basically, it's not meant to be for any old person. Just pick up the silver chest. He's got to be people who know what they're doing. Basically.
Exactly.
I'm saying,
look at the Shem and work out the gematria. It's not enough just to have it next to you. I mean, you have to look at the Shem and actually work it out.
But it's very simple. It's abstract.
This is
chub
chub. So what's the idea? If you're telling me the idea is a malchus, then you're looking at the gematria, then why do you have to have the Shem in front of you?
Why?
The gematria of what?
You why? The malchus
is the chokhmah.
The gematria of what? I'm telling you, the gematria of abstract moben. And they're saying, so why don't you put the gematria next to it?
No, I'm saying instead of it, then you don't see the shem. You have to look at it, and look at the shem, and know that it's
all this is
the gematria.
I know.
You know this is the gematria.
And this is up, so up.
In order to get to the gematria
bottle. No, on the side one, let's bring the side one here. It's going to have some chimel here.
I mean, the configuration of the yud, etc. You're not actually Mechavan 72.
You are Mechavan.
That so all four Chochmas. Basically, it's going.
And you're not being Mechavan.
The Gematria of what? You can't just Mechavan 72. What does 72 represent?
What are they called?
Just what's missing is what
we've only mentioned Malchus. This
and also
it's only first line.
Malchus just interchanges. Yeah. Say it, Malchus just Malchus means Gematria.
So. I'm not sure. You.
That's the lowest
part. So can you just recap? The Etzem, the Rashash is writing down only. We know that from the Gematria, and the Gematria of what of this and then of this and then of this and then of this.
Yeah,
but all together.
All together. Of course.
It has to be all together.
Halab is the ik. If you don't put it all together, then
it's a malchus of all the chokhmas.
Yeah.
It's a malchus of the chokhmas.
Of all the chokhmas.
You have to be all the chokhmas together.
So really, looking at this, you're not after working it out, but you know that you've got, you know this is Ayin Beis, Shaglaich, finished.
No, you're supposed to be looking at all the shemas.
Let's look at the Shemus. If you read the Shemus, let's look at the Shemus.
It represents Ayin Beis.
Yeah,
but you still had to have read them.
You read it, but you have to work it out.
Read it in your mind. Yeah.
It's a Gematria of something. It's not a number. It's a Gematria of something.
Yeah, it's a Gematria of something, but you have to know it itself. You can't just do Ayin Beis, because Ayin Beis could just be...
So
Reish Lam
Beis
could be
the Gematria
of... So means, what does Ma mean? Ma means right hand side, left hand side of the left hand side, which is always the Nukva side, and that's Ma. Ma be the Ma of the right hand side.
But if you're just dealing with, you're only dealing with...
Abba of Yisrael Sam, that's always on the left side.
So you don't need the Ma ben of it, just the Ma.
No, even Abba has a Ma ben of it.
Dema, or Ben Dema.
Okay, so let's turn over the page now. So let's go by
this.
Yechaven. Yechaven.
What was this?
Well, so that's where it's going to. Wherever you see the Lamed, lit. So it's going to, again, the pun. So the Malchus.
The next sphere, the next parasol.
That's right. It came from Arir, that Shefer's coming down to Arir, to...
So,
which is representing Abba of Yusuf Saba.
So, why it's not Mispar Ayin Beis?
Ayin
Beis? Yes, it's Malchias de Chochmois.
No, that's the Shefa. This is Bimkom Akeli.
Surely this should only be.
The Havayah is representing Abba, not representing Shefa. Abba and Yusuf Saba.
It's all in the Chagas. That's the most important word there. The Chagas, the Archampi.
Yeah, that's
the most important. That's the most important Nakuda here because that's the
Kuda Kloli.
Yeah. I mean, we're going specific. Otherwise, you're going completely the wrong place. That's the place we're doing it. Yeah, but
we're doing this type of Shabbat. The type of Shabbat that we're doing.
From the space to the space.
Yeah, but the Chagas.
It's representing this.
No. Yeah, sure.
It's representing a Patsu.
And that's what
leads to the Shabbat. It's representing a Patsu called Abba. And Yisro Saba.
That's
what
you're
right.
And on the other side is representing Ima and
Tuch. Right.
So let's go back to
it. What do you mean Zivik Elion to Abba Vyashta? Yisro Saba.
Where are you reading?
At the bottom of the page.
Yeah. Okay, Zivuk Elion, or call it Zivuk Pinim, it's the same thing. That's the. Why we call it Zivuk Elion? Because we're working with the Chabad of the Chagat. It's the Elion. We'll see in a minute, we're going to be working also with Zivuk Chitzon, which is called the Nine Chagat of the Chagat. That means the lower. We call it Zivuk Tachtan. Mm-hmm. And this, we're trying to work on the Zivuk Elion, with the Chabad, the highest part of that Chagat.
So this is Zivuk Elion, that's the Pinim.
We call it, yeah. Yeah, Shash loves doing this, calling one thing 10 names.
I do that as well.
What?
I also do that.
I should have a teeth cut to that, but I haven't got time to. Now, v'yechaver lezivug chabad dechag. And again, we're doing this, bringing down the shefa, which is produced through this zivug penimi, which is the chabad dechagad, kenizka, the mao ben, the abba v'ima v'yisos saba. Now, this is what we're mechadis. Now, what we're going to bring it down to now.
Did we just make a zivug between abba and Yisrael saba?
No. Now, we're bringing down what was produced via the zivug of arir.
Right.
Now we're going to start making a zivug.
No, I'm just going back over here.
Yeah.
What is that zivug there?
It's not a zivug. It's Abba. It's Abba and Yusuf Zabba. You don't recognize them?
You've
been away for some time. You don't recognize them. That's what he looks like. He changed his glasses.
Oh, you gave up. Yes, you gave up. Okay.
Yeah. The Mepharshim talk about it, the Abba looks like a Yudke Vavke, but it was a similar dog. As opposed to Afuka Eke,
It should be the middle there, no?
Yeah, it could have been different there. It's a similar.
It should be exactly the same as this.
No, that's Shefa.
Ah.
That's Shefa.
Something is missing, because...
Imagine, use your imagination. We understand the halbosha. We understand this esesfiros and bipalzer. We're going to bring it down. There's a lot of things we can add over here. But he takes on, the Rashash takes on the your shoylot and the etchaim, the shakavonis.
So
you basically just brought it to the Malchus of the Chochmas?
No, I didn't bring it down to the Malchus, no. It's not the Malchus. Malchus means Gematria.
But it's a place, it's a place.
No, it's not a place. You're right, officially, but I'm not using it in that context of here.
But you are. That's what you said. It's a king. You said you bring it into it.
You'll see that you're actually bringing it down to the Yesod of Abu.
No, but at this stage, where are we?
It doesn't make sense that I brought it down to the Malchus of Abba and then I bring it back to the Yesod. I'm going to make a zivug in Yesod, which is much higher. We're not talking about the actual Malchus. It's the Malchus de Chochma de Chumchug. Right?
Yeah.
It's the Chochma of the Kesed, the Abba. That's right. So we're not looking at the Mokum per se, it's a type of Shefa. The type of shepherd which was mentioned to us, which we're drawing down.
Until now, we've been speaking about, you start off with Atik, you brought it down to Arich, into a certain place in Arich, then you brought it down to a certain place in
Abba Vima.
Well, let's stick on one side, Abba and then Yashzut. And then Yisro Saba.
Yisro Saba. Right? He doesn't tell us where in Abba and Yisro Saba we brought it.
Probably the same place where it comes
from. Well,
your
guess is as good as mine. But no, he didn't tell us. Now, when we turn over the page, he's going to tell us specifically where we're going to bring it to. And he tells us to the Yesod. Okay. It cannot be that we brought it down to the Malchus already. We don't go up. We always come down.
This is the Shefa.
Yeah.
What is le?
To. We're bringing it down.
This Shefa to a place somewhere.
That's somewhere, that's right.
Where is this place?
The Malchus
de Chochmos.
The Chochmos, yeah. And then we bring it from the Chochmos to the Yesod.
That's very good. So that's a place.
Because Yesod is lower down than Chochmos.
Sure.
Yeah, but where?
What do you mean where?
It's higher, it's much higher. The Malchus of Chochmos are much higher than the Yesod of Abba.
And then we jump all that to the
Yesod.
No,
but it's not the sphere of Chochmos here.
No.
As we know, it's not. This is. You said this is a whole pantsum. You said these are three higher spheres of
Kesed
Atik or whatever. No, Kesed Atik.
This is everywhere.
Kesed Atik. And then you
forget Patsufim. This is an international chart.
That's right. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So this would apply. Confusing me now.
You're too deep here. Let's just take it a bit slowly over here. Mm-hmm. So again, we bring down the Shefa.
Where would Abba be here? Let's say we're talking about in Abba. These spheres would be. This is the Keser of Abba Chochma, Abba Bin of Abba.
No, that's one Keser. That's Keser.
All of this is Keter.
All this is Keser of Abba. Let's say.
Let's say.
Mm-hmm. So where's the Chochmas of Abba?
Okay, we don't have a Kriegerein in the Prote, exactly where in between which one.
Much bigger chart.
Yeah, we need something huge.
Right, the size of this house, you'll be Mechavin you'll probably starve to death by the time you eat that sandwich of yours. Okay, so
you better forget so to eat the sandwich.
The pizza is going to get really cold by the time you finish your bracha, huh? Okay, let's move on. V'chaben zivu chabad v'chagat naz v'mau ben d'abba v'ima v'ya. So that's what we saw already. Now we're going to take a step further. L'hamshech tipa. He calls it a tipa now. They're all, oh, don't be, oh, what's a tipa? What's this?
That's chub chug.
That's right. That's the chub chug that we spoke about. We call it the apsag mau ben. Oh, he said, tipa apsag mau ben. L'yesoy d'chabad v'chagat d'abba v'yisav saba. That's the ikar. You're going to bring it down into a similar mokum, which is the in Abba and Yisro Saba. Now, Vitipas Kasa Kamag, remember? Where's Kasa Kamag? We saw already. This is Kasa Kamag. This is the Kasa Kamag that we're bringing up, remember? This is the abstract. This, what is he talking about? This is called the Tipa.
Ah, that's
and this is the other Tipa. The Tipa of Docha is going to go here. And this Tipa is going to go into where? Into the Kana. Into the Kana should be a soy the Chabaduchaga the Ima Betuna.
Yeah, I can, yeah.
What Mech
taste is? This and this.
Everybody asks the same question. We don't find such a thing that you bring Shefa into Shefa.
Yeah.
Kana is a Shefa. Remember? There's four types of Shefa. And even if you want to talk about mochim or mochim and kelim, you don't bring kelim into kelim, right? Mm-hmm. So if you're talking about usually it's kasa kama kana. We've never seen that you split the first three, bring it into the last four. But that was just a thing.
So, but it's another question: where is kana coming from?
But 1 second, let's compare it to on the right hand side. Okay. The right hand side, we brought the absag moben into a paltzuf called abav into the yisod, into a sphere, which is a keli of abav yisosaba. Yeah. When you go to tipas on the nukva side, you bring that shefa gavalte kasa kamag, which we saw already, into a kana shibi yisoid. So if it didn't rain like kana, it's very good. You bring in also those two shefas into the yisod of ima v'tuna. The shaila is, what is this kana business have to do?
And where is it coming from?
And Mimanasha, if it's there, it should have been brought early on. It should have been over here. It should have been kasa, kamag, and kana as well. Well, what's if again? And the old problems come back. Oh, so you are touching on das now. Ah, nashim kalas, you know. So, so we're not. Right.
Yeah. Why can you say that?
Oh. Well, we're not going to say things midilanu.
No,
but we're going to say things which are quoted.
Nashim dat and kalas.
Yeah, but how does he appear now?
It doesn't have das at all.
Yeah. So how did he get there? What's he doing there? What is it exactly? It seems to be a bit of a problem over here.
Mm.
Right. So we said we don't deal with das. We don't bring down. They don't have a das. So where is it coming from?
What, they don't have a das?
Nashim dat
and kalas.
So they don't have das. It's not represented. Das is not something to. Of course, they have a middle brain. You look up, open the brain. They have a middle brain.
Yeah.
Not choshev. It's not choshev enough to be make a cheshvan of the das. They have a bin yisera. The other qualities up and above eshes chayel ateres bala. They're up and above in different aspects. But the gap of this particular bechina of das. You never know who's watching. The bechin of das, we don't make a cheshbon for it. We don't make a cheshbon. So what's the answer to this problem of kana? So right. So the answer is that there's the Shah Rachamim that speaks about this. And the Shah Rachamim wants to say that the kana that we're speaking about is actually the name of the keli.
Right. And before, what were we talking about? That was the Shefa.
Yeah.
On the previous page.
What?
No, we said Kili as well.
Yeah. According to those opinions, the whole that it's also a Kili thing.
Can we have one
opinion? But they bring down that it's not only a Chiddush Rachmi, it's that he brings down B'Shem, the Arizal, in two different places. Actually, it's more than two different places in the Shah Kavanas and Tefillin, Shah Kavanas and Tzitzit. Also, we find the Arizal calling the Yisoid of Ima Kana. So it's not the Rashash being mechadish this, it's not the Shah Rachamim coming to give a pshet lachir, but rather it's Arizal himself. We don't know the reason why, but it seems to be that the Yisod of Ima is called Kana.
It's one's Ekes because it's Ima, no?
What?
Because Ekes is connected with Ima. The same of imazekin, no?
Kasa, kamak. So why choose kana?
Yeah, that's a question. Let's just make it a bit closer to him.
Yeah, it's connected to ima. The shaili is...
Why doesn't he say here the ma ben sign? He doesn't mention here ma ben of him.
Kana. One minute, Kana's the lowest one, that's the Malchus one, isn't it?
Okay, so...
Yes, it makes sense why it's the Yisoid.
What?
It makes sense why it's the Yisoid.
Why? It's a das.
It's
a das. What does it have to do with Yisoid?
No, but it's the latest one. The latest one, you mean? The
Yisoid is just the clueless of the Chug, which comes from the das.
Hmm?
Yisoid is the clueless of the das. Because the das, the chug, is five chesed and five gevuras, that all gets
gathered together. I would call it kamak. Kamak.
Why kamak?
Kamak is also a chesed in the das. Why dafka kamak? The lowest, why? What's
maybe
the
lowest? Maybe dafka kalas, maybe it's only got one of them.
That's your pshat. Okay, I
push it in. I'm not suggesting.
Right, okay, so I said,
because we do mention kamak as the bina. We said that kamak was the bina, not the chasodim's das. Just like we shifted it all up.
Yeah.
It looks like we lost one of the kasas, if anything.
Yeah. Well, that's why we had to come on.
Maybe it has to do with the bina yisera more like, because the bina's got something extra now. Instead of having a kasa, it's got a kamak.
Yeah. All right. So let me tell you, with the Pesach and Ayim Chodesh, this is the Pesach and Ayim Chodesh of Shalya de Bulemsky. He learns the pshat is that the kana that we're speaking of is actually in the keli yisod.
Yeah.
And Taker very meduik in the loshon there. He says the kana should be yisod. Should be yisod. Not that it's the shame of the keli, but rather it's in the keli. It's in the shibbo, sheyeshbo. But again, you'll come back to the same kasha, is that chozakusha l'duchte, how did it get there? Where did it come from? Where did it come from exactly?
That's what you said.
So whichever ma'adah you want to learn, that it's the shame of the keli, well, it's a little bit more lighter, but then you have a problem with the loshen. And if you work with the loshen, you're going to ask, again, where did this shepherd come from?
And if you look, he actually doesn't say it, does he?
What?
Again, when he speaks about the shame, you see, and he does the kasa and the kamak. Again, even though he's mentioned the kana, he doesn't.
No. What you see over there is the shefa. The kasa and the kamar that you see over there is the shefa coming down.
That's the same one as the previous page.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
And so now where is it going to go to? It's going to go into this long shame over here. What's this long shame?
That looks like...
What is that long shame?
Well, it's a type of kamar, isn't it? I don't
know.
Mitzurut yesh chashlem al bis.
What?
It's a kana be'etzem, but in a way that it's chashlem al bis.
It's chashlem al bis
now?
Yeah, so let's read a little shtickle over here that we have. That is kana. This is the kana that we're speaking about. This is the name, according to Rav Sharia, this is the keli, this is the name of the keli.
Yeah,
so now let's read a shtickle over here. Okay, let's read the shtickel over here in the Shai Kavanas on the second page over here.
We usually do that with the Moichim.
One second, we're running out of time. Let's try to finish it off. Da.
Yeah.
This is the Shai Kavanas in Dav Gimel Amud Beis, Amud Aleph and Amud Beis. Da. Ki kol Baruch Hu B'Yesod. V'tzaruch L'cham Ki Ze Baruch Hu B'Yesod E'Elyon Shel Chochma Nikra Shevir. תחב להמשך בו השפע לחיברו אחר כך, לחברו אחר כך, עם היסוד של בינה הנקרא נסיב. הנה, בשביל הנקרא ברוך ונסיב נקרא ברוכו, שניים שווים בחשבון אחס. גם ברוך וברוכה, עם קלולוס הם רחח, right? 228. אם תוסיף עליהם דלת אויסס של ברוך יהיה גמטרי רלב. והם גמרת לדעלה שמויס אבסג מרובן, והבלסם נמשוכים אל השביל אליון עניקי ברוך. וגם תיכוון במינס ברוכה, נרמוז בברוכה הניסקל תיכוון, כי גם היא גמרת רלה. באופן זה, כי ביסוד הבינה היא, this was not get to us, כי יסוד הבינה, שם הוא עקב במילוי ההים, which is קנה, ושעה שמויס דה אלופים ויהודים נמשוכים שם. That's the picture we show, right? You see, you have kama, kasa and kama going into kana. That's the yesod, he says. That's the yesod of bina. V'hine, this is how you work it out. Hine, zeh ha'eke gematria ralav. If you work out all these letters over here, you come up to 232. V'b'chines tziuro b'zeh ha'ofen. Ki dalet ha'hin shebeshem zeh. אם תציירם בציור דלת ווב, או בציור דלת יוד, בציור גימול ווים, כל אחד מדלת ההין יהיו בגמטריה קוף סמכס. So if you add in, how do you spell kana? Kana is aleph, then, and then hey, and another hey,
so you got two.
And then yud vav dalet, and then hey. So then you, what you're going to do, you can spell hey in three different ways. You can spell hey with hey vav, hey, sorry, Dalet Vav, Dalet Yud, Dalet Vav, and Vav Vav Vav. So in every hay you can have three. Okay?
42.
168. You got me?
168.
Gematria Chav, that's 20. Sorry, an Ois Yud is Gematria Chav. Yud Vav Dalet is 20. So again, you have 168. That's all the hays together. Then when you count the Yud, there's Yud Vav Dalet, that is 20. אם תצייר דלת בבייס וווים, now in the דלת you have two וווים, which represents also another way of spelling דלת, that's another 12.
As right? well as the דלת.
Yeah, as well as the דלת. Okay. Now you count the יוד ווו דלת is 20. Now in the דלת you see there's two little וווים over there, that's another 6 and 6, that's 12. תהיה, היוד בגמטריה למד בייס. That means just the יוד itself, יוד ווו דלת is 20, plus 12 is 32. Chaba lamed beis im a kasach, that's 200. O tikach ois aleph, you take the ois aleph, the beginning of the word, right? Eke with ois aleph. Tzayad tzio yud vav dalet. You see, there's a yud on top, a vav in the middle, and the yud on the bottom, like this. That makes 20, isn't it? That's yud vav dalet. Tzayah hayud b'tzio yud vav dalet. Now it's who lamed beis. Lamed base, because inside the dalet again you have the two vavs. That's also 32. Techaber reish ima lamed base is reish lamed base. Nishar shte oises lamed pei. The only two oises that we didn't work with was the aleph. Sorry, we did the aleph. Lamed and the pei. Humina miloi v'techaberem im ois aleph atzmam. When you mechaber the lamed pei with the ois aleph, it spells azia aleph. Shehem oisis pele. Hu sod shvil adakik anika pele dolois yoda. Lo ilo lo litata kiniska pashut bereshis. What he's referring to is the yisod abba. Yisod abba is hidden inside the yisod ima, and it's called pele. He says this in Shaka Vonis. That's referred to the lamed pei. So because without the lamed pei, you can't have all these oises together, you're going to get to the gematria of lamed reish lamed beis. What does it give you? Again, like the Shara Achamim told us originally, when we did the Ab Sagma Uben over here, we said, what does this have to do? This is not Mochim the Goddess. What we said? He said, it's a Remes to get you to Mirchava and keep your attention on the bow. Sometimes you can get carried away with these commands. You Kav, Mechava, Mechava, you forget what you're Mechavaing Bechlam. Forget the actual word. So the Rashash is putting in these oises over here in order to Mechava. Don't forget, you're doing both. That's why it's put over here.
Well, yes, you mean be okay,
I think
like
we'll stop it here.
Yes, you mean be mechaven all this.
That's right, mechaven all this. All the shav goes into that, the yisod. Okay, shkoyach.